Welcome everybody to another Voice of Nick show. We're making more of our artwork for Posthomerica. All the figures past this point are done. So everybody here is done. Now we just want to do Aeneas on the side. Let's see what we can get here. We'll get rid of Neoptolemus just so that we can see what we're doing with Aeneas's foot. Whoa, what the heck is happening here? That's a strange glitch. Maybe we'll put Neoptolemus's left hand, we'll make that a hand. So, let's do it like this, hold on. Good. Now I'll just take this and what's going on here? What if we had him like, oops. No, that wouldn't work really. Yeah, somewhere like there. So let's move his arm to fit. Just going to use this hand we designed as a guide layer. And I guess we'll make this its own layer for now. This bicep bigger too, because his other bicep is larger than that one. Okay. Good. Let's just fix the outlines. Oops. Okay, good enough. And we gotta delete the stuff that's under his hand here. Then we can merge the hand into the, hold on. We gotta delete this too. Yeah, good. Let's just take his hand here, though, and make it a tiny bit smaller. That's fine. The outlines are just looking a little bit lumpy. That might be to do with the way that our brush settings are made. Now, we'll actually not merge this because this is going to be on a layer, I guess, above the other one. I don't know why he would be running with one open hand and one closed hand, but that's what we got right now. Okay, so let's turn this back on. What else do we want to put in? So, you know, we kind of have to decide on a shape for this. Let's actually do this differently than we drew it. Because there's a curve in the one part, but not in the other part. So let's match the curve. We're going to sort of meet in the middle with this thing. Let's just take a quick look at it. Yeah. A real feather would be on both sides, but I want this to be only one-sided. Let's turn off the underlayer for a second. Yeah, it looks good. Now let's turn off our guides for his hair. So now we want to do, I guess, between these layers, we're going to bring some kind of cloth texture to this, though I don't know exactly what the cloth is going to be doing. Of course, it's gonna get big time bunched up in this area. Let's give it some kind of a why can't I draw this shape? I want to do something like maybe like this. Yeah, that's better. And this will be kind of where all this stuff is converging from. Maybe this is his thing is coming around the side, just like Cassandra's thing is. do something like this. I don't know how this physically makes any sense. Maybe if... All right, let's ditch this, like, concept, whatever this is, and we'll just make it a more sort of traditional thing here. And let's try to give him some kind of drapery. No, I can't do that. I don't think this would work. It would have to be down here. Yeah, that's better. Kind of hard to see what we're doing at this stage, but I think we're pretty much there. Maybe if we gave him some kind of like okay, so that is all we need for Aeneas. I don't really want him to have too many pieces of costume because he's not supposed to be the center point of this scene. In fact, he should be the last person you look at. Good. So now we want to color in three different layers so that they all show up on top of each other. So let's first get the underlayer here. Well, I guess first let's do the... this is going to be harder than I thought. Okay, hold on. We only need two color layers. We need one... under both the clothes and the body, and then we'll just erase part of the body, I guess. And we need one layer for the hand, which exists. Actually, that's not even true because, yeah, we're gonna merge all this, or rather just, if we really care that much too, we can just duplicate this clothing layer, or rather duplicate both of these layers, I guess. Take that, we'll destroy everything underneath the clothes. is this getting erased? Oh, I guess that was a part of the other layer. All right, well, we'll destroy it, then we'll come back later with it. Good. Now, number one, we gotta redo this. We gotta turn the guides on for that. And let's, get this. Good? Yeah, it looks pretty good. It's very bunched up there, which I suppose it should be. Maybe we'll lose like one line, but first we're gonna do this and this and these. Now, everything is in such a way that we could just use one layer for everything. Good. What is this? Oh, that's what we were gonna use for underneath the hand. We don't need that anymore. Great, let's merge all these. We'll turn the Optolemus back on. We will turn the background back on. Aeneas doesn't seem to have any problems, that's good. One thing I would like to do with Aeneas here is let's just change his midsection a little bit. Because of the way that the cloth hits him, it didn't seem like it really matched. So now all the figures are in. After this, we want to do the border around the picture. So as a recap, we have Neoptolemus, son of Achilles, killing King Priam of Troy as they're all sacking the city. We have this nice structure too, which we've never done anything in that style before. I think it looks really good. We have Aias the Lesser, who is attacking Cassandra, who is in this picture, is like defending herself with a sword and sort of clutching onto the statue of Athena while doing so. We got to turn on Athena. I don't know why her thing keeps getting turned off, her spear. All that stuff's happening, and Aeneas on the left is running away out of the frame because he goes on to found the city-state of Rome in future stories. So that all works. I would like to thicken this spear a little bit. Good. Okay, next episode, we're gonna add the border and then we will move on to the 14th and final chapter. So that's exciting as well. Ladies and gents, that's gonna do it for this one. Thank you for joining the show. The channel is called The Voice of Nick. If you wanna see more, don't forget to hit the follow button and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.